A judge will rule this week on whether to allow Missouri voters a say in legalizing recreational marijuana in November.
Tonight, Color 10 investigates a Greene County election error that nearly cost the state the ballot measure, and it still could. Right before the deadline in August, the Secretary of State validated thousands of signatures previously disqualified.
Opponents are now suing the state over the certification, claiming if counties invalidated those signatures, the state shouldn't have changed the outcome. Color 10's investigative reporter Lauren Barnes is live at the Greene County Clerk's office tonight, breaking down the numbers to explain how our congressional District 7 could determine whether recreational pot makes it to voters.
Yeah, Bailey and Steve, the woman who filed the lawsuit to block recreational marijuana from the ballot in Missouri claims local jurisdictions, like the Greene County clerk, should have had the final say in those signature counts. Election authorities don't see it that way.
Frankly, I think it's silly to say we don't want the state, when it's doing something that entails the rights of the people of the state, we don't want them to double check to make sure they're doing it correctly.
The hotly contested issue of legalizing recreational marijuana in Missouri will go before voters this November. That is, unless a judge blocks it this week.
As a former executive director for the Council for Drug-Free Youth there in Missouri for over 10 years, I definitely see the harms that youth use of marijuana causes our young people.
Joy Sweeney is suing Secretary of State Jay Ashcroft. Court records show Sweeney alleges the Secretary of State broke the law by certifying signatures not validated on the county level. The state audited signature sheets after recreational marijuana supporters asked for a preliminary recount.
There were really two main congressional districts that the proponents wanted us to look at. We looked at the whole thing.
One of those two main congressional districts was Southwest Missouri's District 7, where Greene County accounts for most of the population. Thousands of signatures the Greene County Clerk's office originally deemed invalid were verified at the state level following the internal audit.
All good work has more than one set of eyes that's checking along the way. And I think that's the one thing that when you look at this, you know, I'm glad that this organization looked at that, said, hey, we think there's something wrong here.
Local clerk Shane Scholler says part of the discrepancy came from a temporary election judge who mistakenly invalidated signatures of Greene County residents whose address was in the county but did not match their voter registration. Other signatures were initially illegible, but new technology allowed the Secretary of State to digitally verify what election workers could not. Sweeney believes if they were legitimate errors, they should have been handled on the county level.
The county clerks were not even made aware of it. This was all done, you know, very, very quickly behind closed doors. And that certainly lacks transparency.
Normally, I think they would have reached out to us, but they knew that we were literally, that was like literally the week of the August election. And so they went ahead and did that work internally.
Six of Missouri's eight districts needed enough signatures to qualify and got them, but our District 7 would have fallen short of that total if the state had not double-checked, meaning Southwest Missouri is quite literally the difference in getting recreational marijuana on the ballot this November and could still be the difference in having it removed. Color 10 Investigates is also in the process of obtaining records from the state to show those signature sheets in question, as well as the preliminary signature count from Greene County. Reporting live in Springfield. Lauren Barnes, Ozarks First.
All right, Lauren.